Hey everyone, Russell here for NDAX, and today we're going to be talking about the importance of tracking and understanding your crypto. This can help you become a better investor by allowing you to make better decisions about your individual portfolio. Now, luckily, NDAX has a ton of tools that make this information so easy to get a hold of. To get a clearer picture, it's important to understand two major aspects of your portfolio. The first aspect is your asset distribution, and the second is your average purchase price, otherwise known as a book value in the traditional investing world. Understanding your asset distribution is simply understanding the value of all of the different digital assets you're holding relative to the overall value of your total portfolio. And NDAX makes this super easy to see right on their dashboard with this portfolio distribution section. Taking a closer look at this sample portfolio, we can get a better understanding of how much of each asset we're holding and what percentage that asset is of our total portfolio. You can see with this example, in this portfolio, it's 44.3% ETH, 33.3% USDT, 6.3% Bitcoin, and the list goes on and on. Not only does this give you a clearer picture of your portfolio in general, but it also helps you manage the risk inside of your portfolio, as well as staying on track for various guidelines that you may have set out for yourself when you initially started investing. Perhaps you decided that you wanted to hold 60% of your portfolio in high market cap digital assets like Ether and Bitcoin, and you wanted to hold 20% in stablecoins and 20% in alternatives. If you wanted to stick to this 60%, 20%, 20% framework that you originally set out for yourself, well, you could use this dashboard to find out whether or not you're still on track for that. Of course, the assets that you're holding may go up or down in value, meaning that even though you originally distributed your purchases at this 60-20-20 rate, that may not be the current rate that you're at, the current asset distribution. So using this tool, you can decide what do you need to sell and what do you potentially need to buy to get back to that original distribution that you decided you were comfortable with. But the tools on NDAX that allow you to keep track of your portfolio don't just end with this basic view of your portfolio distribution, no. You can actually click the See All button right here, and that will give you a far more detailed view of your portfolio in general, and this is where average purchase price as a concept starts to come into play. Put simply, your average purchase price is just the amount of dollars you originally spent in order to purchase the digital assets that you're now currently holding. Now, knowing your average purchase price is great because it allows you to more accurately reflect on the amount that your portfolio has gone up or down over time. With this portfolio snapshot on NDAX, your average purchase price is roughly represented by your total invested in Canadian dollars. So this is the amount that you originally purchased your digital assets for at the beginning. Now, currently, you can also look at the balance in Canadian dollars, which is a representation of the Canadian dollar value of all of your digital assets. Now, of course, using these two numbers, you can determine how much your portfolio has gone up or your profit over time. And also on this page, you can see the portfolio age and your overall portfolio growth. In this view, you can also see your asset distribution like we talked about before, but you can also see the performance of your portfolio and how much it's gone up or down over time with this performance chart, and you can see this on a day-to-day basis. You can also sort through different categories of your digital assets and compare the performance of each different section of your portfolio. Right here, we can see all of the assets put together, but we can also sort by just Bitcoin, altcoins altogether, and stablecoins as well. So this gives you a way that you can sort of compare different sections of your portfolio. But as we scroll down, we can get even more detailed information about every single different asset that you could possibly be holding on NDAX, and there's a lot of them. You can see here it sorts and puts at the top the assets that are currently inside of your portfolio and sorts them into multiple different columns. The first one is the balance, or how much of that individual asset you have. The second one is your purchase price. This relates to average purchase price that we were talking about before, the amount of Canadian dollars that you originally put in to purchase the asset. The next one is the market price, the current value of it in Canadian dollars. And then, of course, using these two numbers, we can calculate the percentage gain that we've made between our purchase price and the current market price. And also, of course, it will track the distribution of that asset inside of the portfolio, which again, for Ether, the top holding of this sample portfolio is 44.3%. And as a bonus, we can even trade these assets right here from this menu. Let's say, for example, we wanted to buy more Ether. We could click trade and purchase Ether right in this menu. And we can also do the same if we wanted to sell Ether. And the same goes for every single other asset. Now, additionally, you can also dollar cost average from this menu, which is a strategy that I love that allows you to sort of trickle funds in over time to get the average purchase price over the course of a number of different weeks. We have a video on this channel where you can learn more about dollar cost averaging if you're interested. By using these tools on NDAX that allow you to view this information so easily, you can start to become a better investor by making better decisions for your individual portfolio. But with all of that said, I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know if you have any questions about any of these tools down there in the comments, and I'll talk to you again soon.